Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to join Space Observations and the Sustainability course today. And thanks for Professor Lin. Nice talk next week. And this week, the topic is anthropogenic disaster. And the lecturer is Professor Lin too. And Professor Lin is from Center for Space and Remote Sensing Research, National Central University. Okay, Professor Lin.
And good afternoon, everyone. So I think this topic might be the last class of the course program. So hope you already learned something from the program. So the topic of today could be try to monitor the urbanization and the impact on environment by means of satellite observation. Okay, so here goes the topic or sections today. The first one, of course, when you try to use or apply a kind of approach or material, you had better to get more understanding related to your tools. So the first section, I would like to introduce you about the atmospheric radiation and the related to the remote sensing applications. So the applications actually, it could be related to the scattering, interaction, absorption, or emission, as well as reflection. Actually, such kind of interactions could be a function of the wavelength, that is a kind of a spectral bands. Okay, so this is a very important fundamental concept related to the application of remote sensing. So you had better to get more understanding. Once you equip with such kind of the background, then you will be able to forward to the so-called radiative transport equation, which is the most important principle related to the mechanism of satellite observation. So this could be also the fundamental concept or principle as well, but essential for the remote sensing. And the further one could be try to apply the satellite observation to identify the situation of urban development. And here I would like to introduce you with the example in Taiwan. And the another case could be demonstrated in other region, which in the Hanoi Hanoi city. As we all know, the Hanoi actually developed very quickly in recent years. So we would like to examine what's the impact of the urbanization in meteorological environment. Okay, so I think that's the outline of today's topic. So for the first one, atmospheric radiation and the remote sensing. So actually the simple concept is that if the material is relatively transparent to EM wave, then I just mean if the material you target on did not affect the transmission of EM wave, then you cannot get any information from the EM wave. So you had better to select the spectral of EM wave, which are highly or serious impact by the material. No matter the impact or effect are coming from absorption or emission or scattering. And of course, when the EM wave cannot penetrate, a lot of signal or EM wave could be reflected from the target region, for example, the surface. And the remain could be called it transmission. So in general, the atmospheric radiation could be interact with EM wave by means of or in terms of absorption mechanism, emission mechanism, or scattering mechanism. And after such kind of interaction, the remaining one could be called it transmission. Okay, so by evaluate or exam the levels of such kind of interactions, then you will be able to further identify the material characteristic or situation. So that's the fundamental concept related to the atmospheric radiation, which can be applied to the satellite or remote sensing. Okay, so this page just try to indicate or describe briefly for the satellite observation. For example, if the sensor on board the satellite, you may call it or note it by capital D. If the spectral is visible, then you need actually a source. The general source of the Earth system could be the incoming solar radiance. So as you can see, the signal or EM wave emitted from the sun, then penetrate so-called the atmosphere and encounter the surface. When the EM wave encounter the surface, then part of EM wave could be absorbed and part of EM wave could be reflected upward and again affected by the atmosphere. So during the interaction with the atmosphere, which include the absorption or emission or scattering, then the remain signal or EM wave can be observed or sensed by the sensor on board the satellite. Okay, so after that, the satellite just record the signal and then broadcast to the surface receiving station or broadcast or transmitted to the other satellite and then again go back or transport to the surface station. So as the figure indicate, there are some parts related to the satellite observation. Of course, the first part could be called it source or source of the signal. And the second part B could be the interactions between atmosphere and the EM wave. And also the C part C should be similar to the part B, but according to the surface interactions. Okay, so the D is denote here could be a kind of detector or sensor which equipped with some kind of the spectral band. And E, just like what I mentioned, data or signal transportation to other satellite or to the ground station. And after data received, then with the processing system could be analyzed the observation or the data set. And for the further applications, including the land cover, land use situation, or the environmental of the atmosphere. So the received signal after absorption, emission, scattering, or reflection, could be included. So if the material you target on can affect or could be retrieved or further analyze their information according to the satellite observation. So that's the fundamental concept related to the satellite observation. And the following, I would like to introduce you the some part related to the satellite remote sensing, including the source part, the interaction part, including B and the C for more detail. Okay, so for the spectrum could be include the first one visible spectral band and the second one thermal infrared as well as the microwave so this is the detail for the visible spectral as well as thermal infrared spectral as well as the microwave. And the other spectral is seldom applied because of total absorbed by the atmosphere. If you target on the Earth's surface, so it cannot provide any information if you apply that kind of spectral. So mostly the visible spectral, the infrared spectral, and the microwave spectral are usually used for satellite remote sensing. And for the part B related to the atmospheric effect, including the scattering, absorption, actually absorption and the emission. So for the scattering, there are two typical types. The first one, we call it radio scattering. caused from a fine mold particle. Here, the fine mold is relative size, not the exact or actual size. The relative means that related to the wavelength, the particle size, the actual particle size or radius relative to the EM wave, the wavelength of EM wave. Of course, the other scattering type, we call it mean scattering, which caused from the coarse particle, coarse relative coarse particle. And this is the brief introduction to the atmospheric scattering. Generally, there are two typical types, ready and mean, caused from fine mold particle and the coarse mold particle respectively. So the fine mold take the sunlight, I just mean the visible spectrum, as the example. The so-called fine mold, which can cause the type of Brady scattering, are the gases. The gases such as CO2 or ozone or O2 and so on, from gases, since their particles are small enough to cause the Brady scattering part. And the mean scattering, for example, caused from the particle such as the dust, mineral dust or sea salt or black carbon as well. Okay, so this is the general description about the scattering concept. And for the absorption, by the way, for this ideal scattering interaction, did not change the total radius of the EM wave. They just redistribute the directional transported. So the other interaction, we call it absorption stage emission. They may change the total amount of radiation from EM wave. Okay, so just like the description here, the EM wave can be absorbed by the aeromolecular suspend particle such as ozone, carbon dioxide, and the water vapor, and so on. And here is again more detailed description related to the scattering type. Just like what I mentioned, there are two types of the atmospheric scattering. The first one, which caused from the small particle, just like the panel or figures shown here. the blue sky actually mostly caused from the Rayleigh scattering effect. So this is highly reactive to the air pollution. For example, when you go outside and there is a pretty blue sky, it means that most of suspend particles are small enough, which highly dominated by the gases, and so that it means the atmosphere is pretty clear. Okay, and since the Rayleigh scattering are function the amount or effect of ready scattering are function of the spectral. For example, the shorter wavelengths, the higher ready scattering amount. So compared to the blue spectral, the longer wavelengths in red band could be smaller than the blue one. So here just show you the mechanism or the concept related to the blue sky. So theoretically, the scattering amount from blue band is about 9 times to the red band. So it means that when there is a red particle or a red photon appeared, it means that there should be about 9 photons in blue around. Okay, so that's why the sky could be close to blue color when they are almost dominated by the final particle. And the other type could be called mean scattering, which caused by the caused from the coarse particle such as mineral dust or black carbon, a kind of air pollutant, as well as the cloud particle. Sorry. And the scattering amount of mean scattering is independent to the spectral, so that when mean scattering occurred, it means that almost the scattering amount in different spectral are pretty similar. Although they are still somewhat different. So that as you can see, after scattering, the coarse particle of the cloud could be displayed in white color because almost the same amount in different spectral. And if the mean scattering caused from the other particle, such as the air pollutant, it could be a kind of gray color, depends on the scattering capability of the particle. So when you go outside, there is not a blue sky, but a gray sky. It means that a lot of the air pollutant dominate in the atmospheric particle. Okay, so the video just want to identify or emphasize the different type of scattering caused by the so-called the particle size are relative. For example, in the x-axis indicate what kind of spectral you apply to monitor. Okay, it is a kind of wavelength you used for the satellite sensor. And the y-axis indicate the the radius of suspend particle. So here, for example, the air molecule is like this kind of label in radius, and small dust case is about this kind of order, and cloud, and so on. So the relationship between the spectral band or wavelength and the material you target on in particle size is pretty important because I just mean which kind of spectral should you use actually depends on the radius you target on. For example, if you target on the raindrop which equipped with a very large of the particle radius, and you had better to use the longer wavelengths to measure by means of scattering effect. However, if you target on the air molecule or the smoke dust, then you had better to select the shorter wavelength spectral band. Otherwise, you cannot get the optimal signal by means of the scattering effect. So this this figure is pretty important related to which kind of spectral should you use for your target. And the next one I would like to introduce is about the absorption and the emission. So the absorption of and the emission majorly caused by the atmosphere depends on the spectral of the material. I just mean absorption spectral or emission spectral. Actually, they are the same thing. For example, as you can see on the bottom of the panel, according to the black body radiation, the emission out from the sun should be a kind of a smooth curve. Smooth curve is a function of the wavelength. However, if you measure the sun flux or irradiance on the surface, then you will see actually there are some well fluctuated. The fluctuated region actually is a kind of absorption effect by the material suspended in the air. So this is a kind of the absorption effect. Since some specific topic or material can absorb it from different spectral, so it provides the potential opportunity for us to measure the information of the absorber, such as ozone or carbon dioxide, as well as water vapor. So the mechanism here could be described more detail. So there are three experiment exam in the within the laboratory. For example, the first one, the A experiment, assume the laboratory is similar to the vacuum. It means that no material within the laboratory, and if you put in a source, or you can call it emitted source, like the panel shown here, and the after prism scatter, then on the black screen, actually you can see different color spectral. So actually the X axis indicate the wavelength, a kind of spectral. Okay, so this is the ideal situation when there is a kind of the black body radiation emitted from a source equipped with a pretty high temperature. Okay, and experiment B actually is put putting some material into the depository. So the after you putting some material, for example, a cold gas such as carbon dioxide, then there are something changed on the screen. So you can see some black line appear on the screen. So actually, the black line indicate the EM wave in or at that specific spectral already absorbed, or strongly. So this is a kind of the absorption band of the putting gas. So you can put different gas into the depository, then you will be able to have or to summarize the absorption band for each special gas. And after that, the experiment C, you just turn off the emission or the source of radiance, and since the cool gas already received or absorbed very or strong enough energy from the emitted sources, so the stable could be at exciting stage or exciting stage. And if you don't or you stop to support the energy, then the gas could be turned to go down the base stage by emitted the actual energy which absorbed from the source. So after you turn off the emitted source, then you will see on the screen actually just some specific spectral can be found due to the emission of the exciting gas. So according to such kind of experiment, then you will be able to get more understanding about the absorption as well as the emission, So actually, if an open system keep a kind of stable situation, it means that it doesn't mean no energy input and no energy outgoing. It just means the input or the absorbed energy equal to the emitted energy, so that the system could be keep a kind of stable. It just means the total energy doesn't change a lot. So at that kind of condition, you may say the absorption efficiency equal to the emission efficiency, so that the absorptivity equal to the emissivity. Okay, So that's a kind of the principle related to the which law? Not Bill's law. Yeah, that's a kind of the famous radiative principle. So the general description is that when a system keep in stable stage, the absorptivity should be equal to the emissivity. Okay, so that's the essential principle related to atmospheric radiation, especially related to the absorption and the emission. Okay, so here the page just show you some example. The dashed line, the x-axis indicate the wavelength or wave number, and the dashed line here just indicate the blackbody radiation in principle. Okay, and the solid line, solid curve actually indicate the actual measurement. So as you can see, ideally if there is no absorption or emission, and then the black line, solid black line should be consistent with the dashed line. However, because of some absorption effect from different species, for example, the carbon dioxide as well as ozone or water vapor. So based on such kind of observation, then you will be able to identify or try to retrieve the information related to the specific target based on the absorbed situation. Okay, and for the surface, it is pretty similar to the atmosphere, but a little bit simple. Okay, so for the surface interaction, mostly we can just call it reflection. And the reflection actually is a kind of the special case of scattering. It just redistribute the incoming radiance or incoming energy. and for the type of the surface reflection could be simply identified by some kind of the classical type. The first one we call it numbersion or numbersion. The numbersion type indicate the reflected intensity are independent to the direction okay. So no matter which direction you observe, you will get the similar or the same amount of reflective radiance. So such kind of pattern we call it reflectivity type of the surface. And the other typical type we call it specular. It just have only one reflection, only one reflected amount, and the other direction the amount actually quite close to zero. But these two types are not really close to the natural natural surface in the reflection. Normally, the reality of surface reflectivity type are called similar to the bidirectional reflectance. It means that bidirectional, the reflectivity depends on the incoming direction and the observed direction. Okay. And the other type, the other type described on the bottom panel here, named the diffuse. It is pretty close to the so-called reality of the surface reflection type. So it is a kind of a random type that depends on the surface situation. Okay. So due to the different reflectivity in the spectral, even the same material as the described here, for example, for the vegetated target, as you can see, almost there are incoming radiance from the source. However, reflectivity in different spectral could be quite different. For the vegetated, you can refer to the green curve displayed here. So within the visible spectral, the reflectivity could be relatively low than the so-called near-infrared spectral. As you can see, the reflectance in within this spectral is much higher than the visible spectral. So we can use such kind of characteristic to identify so-called the vegetated index, vegetated index, as the right panel shown here. So when a plant equipped with green color actually, it could be coming from the coral field inside the leaf, so that they have higher reflectivity in near infrared and the lower reflectivity in red band actually located here. And for the other situation, although it's still a plan, but the situation could be very worse, so that the few coral field stay in the deep, so that the near infrared reflectivity could be reduced, and the red band reflectivity could be enhanced, so that after such kind of contrast, as you can see, for a healthy plant, the VI index could be reached about 0.7, and for a disease or the used plant, the VI index could be much reduced, as the number shown here. So depends on or apply the characteristic in spectral reflectivity, then you will be able to have further application to the then cover type identification or then use classification. And the other case could be related to the blue ocean. So some information just indicate the major reason of the blue ocean could be coming from the blue sky situation. Actually, this blue sky is not the major factor of the blue ocean. The major factor of the blue ocean could be coming from the spectral reflectivity of the water. As you can see, the blue curve in the blue spectral equipped with very high reflectivity. So the blue ocean mainly dominated by the surface reflectivity in blue spectral band, actually not just coming from the blue sky. The blue sky is not the major one, okay? So for the Earth system, here, if you're talking about the incoming radiance, there are two sources. Of course, the first one, just like we mentioned last week, the first one should be incoming from the solar irradiance. The source temperature is about 6,000 K, and the second one could be coming from Earth system itself by emission, here also the emission, but from the lower temperature, it is about 300 K. And after normalization, they're just a little bit overlapping. So this is quite fortunately for us to identify which one is incoming radiance and which one should be the outgoing radiance. Okay, so since the absorption, as you can see, for the incoming solar spectral, the absorption effect is only a little bit. Most effect are coming from the scattering. But for the outgoing spectral, a lot of absorption could be occurred. So this is quite different mechanism for the interaction. So in short, for the visible spectral band, the major mechanism could be caused by the scattering or reflection. And for the thermal spectral, outgoing spectral, which could be dominated majorly by the absorption or emission mechanism. Okay, so this is pretty important for the application in the spectral band. Okay, so for the spectral, just like what I mentioned, there are three kinds of general spectral widely used for this satellite remote sensing. The first one could be the visible spectral, and the second one infrared, and the other should be the microwave spectral. It is because if you target on the surface, so this table just indicate you the atmospheric transparency. If you target on the Earth system, especially on the surface, so you just can use the transparent spectral, like visible infrared as well as microwave. Okay, so this page just want to show you the main mechanism. For the visible spectral, the main mechanism could be coming or caused by the reflection mechanism. And for the thermal emission, for the thermal infrared spectral band could be caused by the emission or absorption. And for the microwave, they may include two kinds, either or both reflection as well as emission. And for the microwave spectrum, they also include two types. The first type could be the passive, so-called the passive, we just call it microwave radiation. The passive is a kind of only receive, never emitted a signal. For the active, just emitted a signal and then received the emitted signal. Okay, so in this kind of situation, the active sensor in microwave, we call it radar system or radar sensor. If the active system applied to the visible spectrum, we call it LIDAR system. So LIDAR system active in visible spectrum and a radar system in microwave spectrum. Okay, again, this is a kind of spectral reflectivity within the visible spectrum. So as you can see, the different object equipped with different spectral characteristics, so that we can use or to process or identify the length cover type according to such kind of spectral reflectivity. So once you can have the multiple spectral in surface reflectivity, then you can process or identify the length cover type or then use situation according to the multiple spectral observation. And for the thermal spectral, or identify the temperature of object according to the major intensity within the thermal infrared spectral. So this is an example for the measurement in sea surface temperature. And the difference, just like what I mentioned, on the left-hand side, as you can see, the signal mainly dominated by the surface temperature according to the emission mechanism. And the video on the right-hand side actually is according to the surface reflectivity in spectral characteristic. So as you can see, the signal they are take the video or observation at the same time for the same region, but you may get different information when you apply different spectral. So this is a kind of pipeline underground detection on the left-hand side. Although they are covered by or under the dense surface according to their emitted temperature or emitted radiance, we still can have the information if the pipeline is not so deep. Okay, so for the comparison between optical and the microwave, here we use the star image as the example. Okay, so as we just introduced, for the visible image, the main mechanism could be caused by the surface reflectivity. And for the SART, actually is a kind of backscattering according to the surface roughness. So as you can see over the smooth region, there are few backscatter signal coming back to the receiver. So when you compare the satellite image, as you can see on the optical image, there are two kind of small air pole located here. But for the SAR image, actually they just only one air pole located on the left hand side. On the right hand side, they can see any structural signal of the air pole. So by comparison, according to the mechanism of the image observation, so that you can have the conclusion related to on the air pole on the right hand side are just a kind of painting air pole, not a real one. Okay, I think already 1 hour passed. Is there any question so far from students? If there is no question, I will continue the topic after 10 minutes break. Okay. So we may come back for the topic on on about 7:05. Okay, we may continue the topic. Before we continue, is there any question so far? Okay. If you have any question, you may have after the end of the introduction as well. So for the radiative transfer equation, especially described for the satellite observation, normally it follows the energy conservation principle. So as the panel or scheme indicate here, so incoming radiance could be separate into the reflection as well as the absorption, then the remain. So according to the energy conservation, you may get this kind of equation pretty to the absorption, or as we all know, the scattering effect could be change the direction of transportation. So the detail could be include not only the absorption but also the scattering out or scattering in. And also, if the material or the location could be provide the emission with the similar spectral, then the emission part should be included for the transport equation. So this is a kind of figure scheme. And in mathematic form, you may have the following formula. Actually, the meaning is that the changes between incoming and the outgoing is a function of emission, absorption. Emission could be positive contribution. Absorption could be negative contribution. And scattering out also negative contribution, as well as scattering in is a kind of positive contribution. So this is the general form related to radiative transport. I mean for all of the spectra. Okay, and if you take the visible or near infrared spectra as the example, so the incoming source on the right hand side, and after penetrate the total column of atmosphere, encounter the surface and the reflected by the target, then go into the sensor on board the satellite. So for the satellite observation, potentially contribute signal could be include the phase radiance by scattering in. And also, if the temperature is high enough, also can be emitted the visible spectra. And scattering out, of course, affected by the scattering effect and the associated with some part of the absorption. So the total amount received by the satellite actually include the phase radiance and the information contribute by the target area, as well as the multiple effect from the environment. Okay, so for the satellite observation, actually not include the surface information, but also the atmospheric information. So this is a kind of the mathematic formula. So the total signal received by the satellite include the phase radiance and the direct from target, as well as from effect from the environment. So if you can separate each item clearly, then you may provide both the surface information and the atmospheric information. That's a kind of remote sensing technology. Okay, and for the thermal spectra, especially for the Earth system, since we don't have the natural source within the Earth system for the visible spectral emission, so we can just skip the scattering part or reflection part. So the remaining one could be just emission from the surface and the atmosphere, as well as absorption of the atmosphere. Of course, the surface emission should be considered efficiency of emission. We call it surface emissivity. Okay, so this is a two typical formula for the thermal infrared spectral as well as visible spectral. Okay, so once you equip with such kind of background knowledge, then you will be able to apply the spectral data observed from the satellite. So for the topic related to the urbanization, actually it is a kind of the land cover or land use changes. So according to the Landsat satellite observation in visible spectral band, if you take the Taipei area in Taiwan as the example, so this is the this is a kind of a two color image taken from Landsat multiple spectral band in visible. So in 1980, the building region, as you can see in light blue color region, is still underdeveloped. But 10 years later, as you can see, a lot of region already replaced by the man-made surface. I just mean maybe the park, the road, or the building. And 10 years later, in 2000, a little bit expanded, and the further year in 2010. So this is just the outlook from satellite image. Then actually, for the research or more detail in quantitative assessment, you should have more detail processing. For example, you based on the spectral reflectivity characteristic, then you will be able to do the land cover or land use classification. So this is the example from 1990 to 2009, according to the Landsat image. So different color actually indicate the different land cover type after classification. So this is a kind of the result, quantitative result, after land cover type classification. So it's good. Some data affected by the cloud, then you may get the changes no matter in vegetated region or in in man-made surface or even the water surface. So the result within the 20 years in Taipei region, as you can see, about 10% decreased or changed from vegetated surface to the man-made surface, about 10%. Okay. And for the urban heat island effect assessment, actually, according to the general definition, you should have the surface temperature information. So according to the thermal infrared spectral, then we may have the temperature information for the surface region. So this is a kind of the brightness temperature directly from satellite observation. The brightness temperature here is assumed the surface is a kind of a black body which equipped with 100% of emissivity. But in reality, it should not less than 100%. Okay, so for the overall assessment, as you can see, the ISA index indicate the fraction of man-made surface compared to the natural surface, which include the vegetative as well as water surface. So from 1990 to 2005, as you can see, the surface then use already much changed. And according to the surface temperature also changed caused by the surface type or land use type changed. So as you can see, the more urban development, the higher urban heat island effect already observed from the satellite. Okay, so for the detailed analysis, we may try to separate the levels of urbanization. So firstly, we select so-called the core region of urban area. And the other type could be the suburban region and as well as the nature region. And each region, we select three kind of location. So this is the analyzed result from satellite observation. So the x-axis actually is the time series, and the y-axis is a kind of a man-made fraction, which can be used for the index related to the urban development. So as you can see, the urban development in area could be increased along with years in Taipei region. And the heat island effect also increased, which mainly caused by the land use type. So here we just use the brightness temperature directly for evaluate or for the estimation of urban heat island effect. Different color actually indicate different region. For example, the blue one indicate the core region of urban, and the red one indicate the suburban region in the urban heat island effect or surface temperature. So as you can see, the more man-made surface, the higher temperature. Actually, it the main factor could be dominant by the surface emissivity. Later, we will have more detailed analysis based on the station measurement. And if you try to correlate the urban development in terms of ISA, man-made surface ratio, as well as the temperature increased, then you will see actually for the urban urban region, suburban region, and rural region, there is not, or although there is a trend, but not quite clear, especially within the core region of the urban. So for example, the same developed region actually could have different temperature levels. So it might be caused from the three dimensional. I just mean it is not so clear in dark. anyway, the indicator should be that kind for the spell of man-made surface. It could be dominated. The surface temperature could be dominated by two-dimensional only. But for the dense man-made surface, it could be related to the building model. It means that not only two-dimensional, but also three-dimensional. So we would like to investigate the impact from the three-dimensional. So so far, we just can have the information in two-dimensional from satellite observation directional. So we still have some effort need to be processed in obtain the three-dimensional information. So this is the 1980 for the study region in urban development situation. And 10 years later, then in 2000 and 2010. So we try to build up the building model according to the related data set. For example, the fundamental data set of the building. Then this is a kind of a result. We try to construct it for each building from the fundamental data set. And after we got the building model, then we may have more detail associated with the GIS system, including the information of building coverage ratio, in short, BCR, and the floor area ratio, FAR, in short. Actually, the floor area ratio indicate the model, building model structure in three-dimensional. So we would like to analyze associates with the surface temperature. So far, we just can provide the brightness temperature for the study region according to the satellite observation directory. But actually, based on the land cover type, then we can assign or estimate the surface emissivity for each land cover type. Then according to the brightness temperature associated with its the emissivity, then we will be able to calculate the surface temperature, like the bottom panel displayed. Okay, so after that, we can reanalyze the relationship between BCR and the LST, as well as FAR and the LST. So from the BCR relationship with the UHI, as you can see, it is pretty similar to the previous one. here. So it is pretty similar. For the region in the core urban area, actually it is not unclear. It is still unclear for the relationship, as you can see here. So it should be dominated by the three-dimensional modeling. So if you if you analyze with the FAR in by considering the building model, then the relationship could be much improved. So this is the clear conclusion that when the correlation correlation between FAR and the urban heat island intensity is more significant than the counterpart of the two-dimensional in BCR, especially in the core area of urban region. Okay, so the effect, since the as the rainfall rate or precipitation, so we just select the ground based station for the data set. Okay, so this is the data set from ground based station from 1961 to 2010. So as you can see, the air temperature actually is increased, and the diurnal variation between daytime and nighttime turned to saturate in the especially in the core region of the urban area, core region. It means that the then use of the core area already saturated, so that the development of the urban just can be focused on the building model, which related to three dimensional from the building model. So just like the figure shown here. So this is a kind of a two-dimensional. And the bottom one actually is a kind of a rural region and urban region. So for the urban region, because of the requirement for the development, so they need to try to remodel the building for more space. So for the three-dimensional building, much increased or constructed as the result. So as you can see, when there is a dense higher buildings among the core region, so the temperature variation between daytime and nighttime could be saturated. And the further analysis could be focused on the urban heat island intensity increased and the regional precipitation between rural and the urban. So the mechanism is that the normal situation, especially within the summertime in Taiwan, especially in Taipei City, there is during the summertime, the southwest monsoon could be dominant around the west part of the Taiwan island. So the southwest Tan Monsoon actually equipped with a pretty high water vapor content, and according to the effect of terrain uplift, then there are that of the cloud, dense cloud, could be accumulated and formation. Then generate a lot of thunderstorm, so that the rainfall or precipitation within the mountain area could be much more than the urban region. However, when the urban heat island effect intensified, could be generated or enhanced the local convection around or within the urban region, so that some of the water vapor could be uplift or take away when they pass by the urban region. Then a lot of dense cloud format, and then provided or increased the regional rainfall within the urban region, so that the amount of the mountain area in what rainfall rate of precipitation could be reduced. So as a result, the difference between rural and the urban region could be reduced, caused by the enhanced caused by the enhanced local convection. Okay, so this is the effect evidence of the urban heat island effect on regional precipitation. And for the other region, could have the similar situation. For example, if you look at the area of the Hanoi city from satellite observation, so the land cover type changes also coming from the landsat satellite observation. So as you can see, the different color indicate different land use type. For example, the red indicate the red residential region expanded, especially the region on the right hand side, obviously. Okay, and the land surface temperature also can provide it from landsat satellite in thermal infrared spectral. Okay, so although they are not so obvious, but actually the value already much increased. And here could be the relationship between or the effect of the urban heat island effect, or you can say urban development urbanization effect on the meteorological parameter, including the temperature. The different different trend indicate the different region. For example, the green one indicate the rural region. As you can see, the increment is less than the urban region in air temperature, especially for the humidity. As you can see, the rural region keep the same along with the urban development, but for the cold region, actually much decreased. It means that the it may cause by the higher temperature as well, and the wind speed also have some difference. The total rainfall, as you can see, the effect could be displayed by the decrease of the rural region although the increase within the urban region just a little bit, but compared to the rural region, it already indicate the same trend in Taipei City. Okay, so this is just the example for the application to the urbanization monitoring by means of the satellite observation. And you may have more detailed analysis related to their impact actually. So that's all for today's topic. The discussion may include actually based on the visible spectral image observed from the satellite can provide the urban development situation and the associated with the three-dimensional information, you may identify the urban heat island intensity more accurately. And the associated with the thermal infrared observation, you may try to estimate or assess the effect of urban development on the urban heat island intensity. So this is just a kind of a general application. Actually, for the thermal infrared spectral, it could be applied for other application. Actually, include the green resource related to the geothermal energy and so on. Okay, so I think I will stop here for today's introduction. So here is a reference related to today's topic. Thank you. If you have any question, I will be happy to respond.
Thank you, Professor Lin. Have any question? Oh, I see a question in chat room from Vergara. What is the process to get a relationship between UHI and the ISA? Professor Lin, can you see that?
Sorry.
Yes.
What's the procedure to get the what is the procedure to get the relationship between UHI and the ISA? Okay, so actually ISA you may estimate you mean how to get the ISA value and the UHI value, right? So for the, let me show you again. Okay, so ISA actually is a kind of fraction to the nature between man-made surface to the nature surface. So the ISA could be estimated. For example, if you select a window, a moving window, then you can have the building fraction within the window according to the result after land cover or land use classification. For example, if you the window the pixel within the windows, the window are all building pixel, then the ISA value could be equal to 1. if the fraction, the number of building pixels are 50%, then the ISA value could be 0.5 only. Okay, so that you can get the ISA value. And for the UHI urban heat island intensity could be the difference in temperature between urban area and the rural area. So in processing, you may select a point in mountain area as the rural temperature, and all of the temperature just compared to the reference temperature, so that this one is example. If you select the green point as a reference, then all of the temperature compared to the reference, then the difference can be estimated as the urban heat island intensity according to the definition. So that if you can have the surface temperature distribution, then you may get the UHI distribution as well after you select a reference point. So once you can get the ISA and the UHI, then you will be able to do the analysis between ISA and the UHI intensity. So did you got the answer for your question? Okay, so what you mean is how to get just use the linear just use the regression in slide 36. I think it is quite straightforward. You just use this, for example, use the red points with these two values. Each point equipped with ISA value and the UHI value. And according to the regression model, then you can select the type. For example, linear type or nonlinear type, then you will be able to get the regression result associated with the correlation coefficient or a square value.
Hello, can you hear? Okay, yeah. Professor.
Yeah.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So, good afternoon, Professor. So I have one question. It says, so we know when two frequency and the phase, the energy are same. So, wave when they are to attach each other, there will be appear interference offset. So, I mean, this wave, their energy will be dropping. So, my question is that because the satellite use the radar and to made the one a map of the land. So if this land has any radar station that their frequency and their phase is the same for this satellite's radar wave, so will be they appear interference offsets. So make the satellite radar will be disappear. So maybe in the radar map inside this part become black. So will this happen in the satellite map? So this is my question. Thank you.
Yes. This is it is a kind of topography effect. It's still the effect could be enhanced by the better spatial resolution, especially within the mega city, since there are a lot of high building, so that they may have the shadow. So once you have the shadow, the signal just a kind of contribution from atmosphere, not include the surface contribution. So it still have the shadow effect. But if you just use a kind of kilometer spatial resolution, I don't think the effect is obvious, so that you may neglect such kind of effect.
So when the radar wave are released by the sunlight and they're going to reflect on the mountain, so the mountain as a something part will become a shadow and something part will be bright, and is it because the same effect?
For the radar observation, I mean radar data processing, it is another story. Okay. So in general, it should be associated with so-called the digital terrain model to process the radar image. Otherwise, you did have no idea about this is the shadow or from the equivalent target. So since the radar observation is a kind of a slant pace, so we actually the radar data processing is another story. And the things if you talking the radar actually the temperature, the brightness temperature, seems dominated by the surface emissivity. Dominated by the surface emissivity, not it depends on which time period you observe. Because when you use the microwave spectral, not only the emissivity but also the reflectivity also contribute. So it is a little bit complicated, more than the thermal infrared spectral as well as the visible spectral.
Okay, thank you, Professor.
Yeah.
Have any more questions? If no more question, thank you, Professor Lin.
Yeah, no problem. It's my pleasure. So at the end, thank you for attending this topic. If you still have any question after the class, you can contact with me by email, actually.
Okay, everyone, please write down your answer for last two class by the Google phone, and later we will write down in chat room.
Thank you.